What's up, YouTube? This is Too Raw for TV, all right? So, before I get into this video, I want to give a shout-out to Pro Basketball Updates, all right? Because he broke this story in a video, and the story is that, and I was listening to his video, and it may very well happen, prompt me to do a video of my own, that today's presser, by, I think his name is Neil O'Shea. He's the general manager of the Portland Trailblazers. It may sway Dame Lillard to potentially leave Portland. And I had to look for it myself. I wanted to see exactly what was discussed. So during this presser, where he's talking to the media, he's talking about the future of the Portland Trailblazers. I think he's been in this capacity for, I read, since 2012. And basically, it contradicts a lot of what Dame Lillard seems to be just asking for. Well, you know, Dame Lillard put out that cryptic tweet, I think the day after Portland was eliminated in six games by a shorthanded Denver Nuggets team. And you look at the fact that Dame put out that tweet, which seemed to suggest a lot of frustration on his part. You know, Dame has come out and said that they need some serious roster changes. And he even came out and was jockeying for Jason Kidd to be the next coach of the team. Well, Terry Stotts was fired. We, you know, pretty much all of us saw that coming. Jason Kidd, however, will not be a candidate for the Portland Trailblazers. And I saw some reporters who have covered sports and have covered the NBA for decades have said that it was very unusual for a player like Dame Lillard to specifically, at least publicly, jockey for a particular person to be the coach. That is kind of unusual. So, what I'm seeing, right, when you look at Neil O'Shea and he's saying that he thought the issue was largely coaching, which a lot of it was, okay? And that's why he thought that Terry Stotts should be fired. But what he also says, if you look at what he's saying, he doesn't seem to want to make much roster moves. He's basically saying the roster's fine, and that basically he's kind of putting it on the players. He's saying that, you know, the problem is the defense. They were ranked 29th defensively. A lot of that was coaching and personnel. And that they don't really need to. Basically, he makes no plans on making any significant roster changes. And basically, they're going to have to get a coach, I guess, that is more defensive-minded, knowledgeable of defense, and that they need to shore up on that end of the court. And he thinks that if they shore up on that end of the floor, that'll be enough. I don't think that's going to be enough. The way that they play and the roster that they have, I don't think you can win in the NBA with frickin' Frack in the backcourt, like just yakking up threes, playing hero ball. They need a third guy. In today's NBA, to be a championship team, for the most part, you need some type of third, scorer, some type of third guy, and Portland doesn't have that. And I think, you know, I've already said that I think that they need to get rid of McCollum, trade him for somebody, keep Lillard, but Lillard needs to be more. The offense needs to be more evenly spread out. They need some more talent. the general manager doesn't believe they need to make any trades. Also, I get this sense that the general manager is basically trying to reassert his authority in this situation. And he's going to make the coaching decision. And, you know, I think Nurkic has come out and said that he's also unhappy with the roster right now. And whether he will come back will be contingent on if they make some changes as far as with the roster. And as I said, the general manager, who I believe his name is Neil O'Shea, he said that he's not going to make any significant roster changes. So there's a conflict of interest right there. So if that's the case, then both Dame Lillard and Nurkic may be gone. Because at this point, I think Lillard is looking at reality. Look, he's not 25, 26 years old anymore. He's 30. And he's peaking right now as a basketball player. Does he really want to waste another 2 or 3 or 4 years here? You know, this guy's a great player. He's a future Hall of Famer. And what I dislike about this situation is this is exactly why players have the mentality that they have now. Look, as a fan, I don't like what Kevin Durant is doing. I told you that. I can't stand it. As a fan, I cannot stand what Kevin Durant, what LeBron James, what a lot of these guys have done in the recent past as far as ganging up, joining super teams, right? But at the same time, I understand why they're doing it. Because what is the point of being loyal to these franchises? Look what they did to Isaiah Thomas. What did he get out of that? Dame Lillard has been loyal to this franchise. And, you know, this guy put up a 55-point, 10-assist performance. This guy consistently averages well over 30 points per game each postseason. Is he perfect every game? No. You're going to have bad shooting nights. But for the most part, this guy has put on some phenomenal runs, and he is right now arguably the greatest player in Portland Trailblazers history. Now, some people might throw up Bill Walton, but Bill Walton didn't play that long for Portland. Like, I mean, he played for Portland, but and he did bring a championship, but, I mean, how long was he there? What, 5 years, I guess, off the top of my head? 6 years? Okay. Dame has been there for a much longer period of time. You can bring up Clyde Drexler. Maybe still Clyde is the greatest because he did go to, you know, two finals. But I'll say this. Lillard is the most explosive scorer that we've ever seen at the very least. And he's definitely top 2 to 3. Probably top 2. Some will say he's the greatest Portland Trailblazer. And at this point in time, if you look at all the championship teams, Portland doesn't stand a chance. And if Dame Lillard really wants to win a championship, he may have to leave. Now, before that, I thought maybe with the tweets, Dame was letting off some steam. You know, remember Kobe one time in an interview before, I think, the 2007-2008 season, a radio interview, he pretty much said he wanted to be out of there. But a lot of that was frustration because the organization wasn't fucking, they didn't seem committed to winning. They weren't making any roster changes. They weren't making any significant roster moves. They was playing with a bunch of mediocre players. Okay, and that gets frustrating. Kobe at that time was also nearing 30 years of age. He saw what was coming down the road. He knew that he couldn't consistently average 32, 34, 36 points a game. And he was getting tired of that heavy lifting. Dame Lillard's getting tired of the heavy lifting. Dame is 30. So when you put out that pressure, you're trying to force the organization's hand. But if he's saying this, and they're kind of like saying, well, we're not going to make any roster changes, or at least the general manager, unless the owner checks him and fires him, maybe it's time for Dame Lillard to depart from this team. But tell me what you guys think, man.